Market's favorite stocks report earnings this week, Amazon, Alphabet, and Facebook. Sam Stovall, Chief Investment Strategist at CFRA. These are the remaining FANG stocks.
That's right. And FANG stocks really are sort of guiding investor optimism because take out the FANG stocks from the S&P 500, and it's estimated that earnings would be lower by about 6%. So really, the FANG stocks are adding a lot of octane.
Do we get blowout quarters like we did with Netflix, especially for Amazon and Facebook?
There's certainly that possibility. I think that the wind is behind their back right now. I think in terms of earnings for the market as a whole, we were expecting 10% in the first quarter, got 15.5%, and we are now on target for the 22nd consecutive quarter in which the actual earnings exceed the beginning of quarter estimates. We're already up at about 7.5% versus the original estimate of just below 6%.
And what is your take on the tech sector in the S&P 500 overall? It's now above where it was in March of 2000. So it's pretty worrisome in the minds of some investors to see that comparison.
Well, yes, but let's face it, 8% of all bull markets since World War II have traded in new high territory. Otherwise, how do we go from 100 in the S&P 500 benchmark to the early 1940s to more than 2,400 as we are today? So I wouldn't just say that because we are above that 2,000 level peak for the NASDAQ that we should worry. I think look more toward valuations. With us trading at about 18.5 times 2017 estimates for the S&P 500 technology sector, that's basically on target with the S&P 500, not the difference between tech being twice as expensive as the market as a whole back in 2000.
So when we take that top line S&P 500 tech sector number between now and March of 2000, it's not an apples to apples comparison.
Oh my gosh, no. It's a number that, if anything, would serve as virtual Valium to calm investors' nerves.
All right, I think that makes people feel a lot better.
Absolutely.
Sam Stovall, thank you so much.
My pleasure.